The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Gird your loins and light your lamps, and be like servants who await their master's return from a wedding, ready to open immediately when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds vigilant on his arrival. Amen, I say to you, he will gird himself, have them recline at table, and proceed to wait on them. And should he come in the second or third watch and find them prepared in his way, blessed are those servants." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Naiwanan na po ba kayo ng eroplano? O kaya ng bus, ng tren, ng kung ano mang sasakyan? O muntik pa lang kayong maiwanan? No? If you are in an airport, madalas po maririnig po ninyo na ina-announce TR-517 or something like that is boarding. So, you should be there at the gate already. And then after mga 5 minutes or several minutes, naririnig mo naman, na naman po ulit, last call for PR5 something for boarding. Hanggang minsan tumatagal. At maya-maya, meron ka na makikita na tumatakbo. May mga dala-dala, no? Kapag nakakakita ako ng ganyan, sasabihin ko sa sarili ko, "Nako, patay ka sa mga nagaantay na mga pasahero doon sa eroplano na yon." Mga matatalim na mga mata, lalong-lalo na yung mga may hinahabol na mga appointments, may hinahabol na mga other flights, connecting flights. And when you reflect on it, yung binasa nating Ebanghelyo, the first imagery that really comes into my mind is the imagery of an airport. Busy, even lalong-lalo na before the pandemic, yung airport o kaya mga terminal ng bus o kaya ng train. No? Busy lagi yan. And I was thinking, paano kaya maiiwasan yung mga ganitong pagkakataon that yung mga passengers are still loitering around, no? At wala doon sa lugar na dapat andun sila, waiting for their airplanes, for their trains, or for the buses. If you notice, yung airport po kasi ay hindi na lang po siya lugar kung saan sasakay ka ng eroplano. Andun na rin po yung mga duty-free, andun na rin yung mga kainan, andun na rin yung mga bilihan ng pasalubong. Everything that would distract a passenger from what he or she is supposed to be doing in that place. Pumunta ka doon para sumakay ng eroplano at para makapag-travel. No? That many of us would also use the airport, lalong-lalo na yung mga modern airports ngayon na ando doon na yung mall, ando doon na yung mga bilihan, ando yung mga duty-free. Everything that distracts. Meron na ngang yung ibang mga airport na may sinihan, meron pang massage, patawag nito, area. And something that can actually make you forget about your flight. The most important thing, that the reason why you are there in the airport. Why did I come to that to this kind of reflection? Sapagkat yung binasa nating Ebanghelyo, it's about being ready. It's about being prepared. It's about always ready when the Lord comes. Pagka tumawag na yung Panginoon ng PR501 is already boarding, you should be there at the gate, ready to board. All the disposition. Alam mo kung ano yung bag, kung nasaan yung bag mo, ilan yung hawak mo, na mga bags, na kaya yung iba may mga naiiwan na mga gamit sa airport. Ang dami kasing distraction. In our lives, ganun din, no? Ang daming distractions, ang daming mga bagay na pwedeng mag-prevent us from focusing into what we should be doing, into what we should be thinking, into where our heart should be. Ang daming distraction. Even in prayers. No? Alam ko, pagpunta nyo rito, ang mindset po ninyo is really to focus on praying. But when you pray, no, I know you would agree with me with this, biglang papasok sa isip ninyo, naiwanan ko bang nakasaksak yung plancha, nakapagbayad na ba ako? All the other concerns would enter us. These are distractions. At some point, when we would complain about that, when we were in the seminary, we were told that those distractions are actually what we bring to the Lord. Those are good things. Those are good distractions that when you bring it to prayer, your prayer becomes more meaningful. But there are also many other distractions in our lives that really prevents us from seeing the goal. Why are we really here in the church? Why are we really there in an airport? Why are we really there in a terminal? Why are we really there in school? Why are you really there in working, in your office? That is to work. Because of the so many distractions, we forget. And that's how we become foolish, when we lose sight of what we are supposed to do. Kaya nga, very, very clear yung instruction ng gospel sa atin, be vigilant. Because the world really has so many distractions. Andiyan na yan eh. The airport, tatanggalan mo ng mga bilihan, tatanggalan mo ng restaurant. No, it's not going to happen. It's a business opportunity. Nakikita yan ng mga tao. Kaya lang, it's also the same thing that prevents us from really focusing on why we are there. Kaya nga, every now and then, we have to re-ask ourselves the question, bakit nga ba ako andito? Bakit nga ba kayo andiyan? Andi dito ngayon sa loob ng simbahan. Bakit nga ba ako nasa school? Bakit nga ba ako nagtatrabaho? Because every now and then, we would to clear ourselves from all this distraction. Vigilance, my dear friends, is in every part, in every step ng ating buhay. The world as it is will offer so many distractions. The world as it is will also provide us with tools and instruments. But if we do not put them into proper perspective, baka maiwan tayo ng eroplano. Darating ang panahon na sasabihin sa atin, Flight 501 is boarding. Are you there at the gate? Or are you still doing your groceries?